Mose Wright. Mose Wright was a man indeed, and a sharecropper who church members simply called preacher, because they knew him to be a man who was still Holy Ghost Spirit filled, even though it had been years since his last sermon. But in the late summer of 1955, Mose was also great uncle to one nephew nicknamed Bobo, who was brand new to the hushful and sultry southern summer nights and those Mississippi days of endless white hot suns when the cotton fields were all rolled up just after first plowing. And in that early Sunday morning hour at his cabin home, among the other tar paper shacks sitting on cinder blocks, when Mose heard gravel moving under approaching tire wheels, along with headlights flooding his screened-in front porch, and then the grave, steely sound of a truck door slamming, Mose found himself standing there, still and as wooden as the cedar and persimmon trees in his front yard. Standing still and wooden, but not as sturdy and not as tall. And as the harsh flashlight glare preceded the footsteps of fuming white shadows advancing across the floor of his home, suspending heartbeats from room to room and halting breath, like a thick, sweltering murkiness moving low across the bayou, Mose found himself as still and motionless as a lynching noose, frozen against the chill of a midnight black, starless sky. Days later, Mose found himself standing beside a muddy river, staring into those waters that the Choctaw tribes called Tallahatchie, meaning river of rocks beneath the surface like headstones, but sharp and heavy like a metal piece of machinery made of iron that becomes steel teeth cutting and ripping and tearing into flesh and shooting lead holes into skull and bones with barbed wire attached, pulling at muscle and tissue and ligament while holding down below and under in the influx and inflowing of other rivers rising and other bodies of water swelling, the bloated, bulging, black bodies and unknown spirits and souls called to witness from deep down underneath the underwater lynching of a mutilated, disfigured, executed, innocent child. This is what I want him to do for me. Mose Wright was a man indeed, and a sharecropper who church members simply call preacher. And although anybody in the county, black or white, might tell you that any man can only die once, Mose knew that he himself had died 1,000 Delta nights. He died first when he could not stand up for himself in his own home. He died again when he could not stand up for his wife, Elizabeth, and for his own sons and grandsons. And before the last river's rising, he died once more because he could not stand up for his nephew Emmett and for the boy's mother Mamie all the way up north in Chicago. So Mose decided that he wasn't going to die anymore. He knew that if he could not stand up this one last time, that the sweet smell of honeysuckle on the Tallahatchie riverbanks would never ever smell the same in his memory again. And that's why some say that on that morning, in that dingy, pale green-walled courtroom, against that hateful, cold, whitewashed daylight, Mose finally stood up as tall and as sturdy as the cedar and persimmon trees in his front yard. And that's why some say he stood up and pointed his finger directly at the murderous, depraved, heinous, vile perpetrators and simply said, There he. There he is. There he. There he is.